Welcome back to Canada. Welcome back to
Thank
Toronto.
You. Thank
How you. Guys
Thank
doing?
You.
Everything good?
Yeah, great. Real good.
Everything
real
is
good.
Lovely.
You guys are really busy right now. There's all sorts of shows going on. What's new? What's new and exciting in the lives of the guys in 98 Degrees?
Well, we were actually here last week. We did a show here at the Opera House, which was great. Everybody came out. Thanks a lot for showing up for that. And we've just been really busy with our new single, Because of You. We've been traveling all over the world, Asia, Europe, Canada, the U.S. So it's been a lot of fun. We've just been everywhere.
All right, you mentioned that. Why don't we check out a little clip from the video, get all excited, and then we can chat a little bit about it. Here you go, Because of You.
You're my sunshine after the rain.
Proud of you guys of that. I mean, that's pretty impressive.
It was very fun. We had a lot of fun doing the video, and great director, great concept, everything about the video.
Okay, now, in this day and age, though, of digital effects, a lot of people are going to say they weren't really up there on the Golden Gate Bridge.
We were.
A lot of people think that it was some digital special effects, some type of imagery and stuff, but no, we were actually on top of the Golden Gate Bridge, and we were actually very, very scared.
You could tell because, if it was fake, Jeff wouldn't have been holding on to
I'm
the railing.
I'm holding on to every
like
shot like this.
His face would have been petrified like it was.
It was
Did you guys
scary.
Have to get all sorts of special permits and safety restraints?
Oh, no, they didn't care about the safety restraints. They just care about the permits. Now, there were railings on either side, and it actually is pretty wide, but with 40-mile-an-hour winds, you were kind of still just holding on and making sure you didn't get blown off the top of the
That's
bridge.
An amazing effect. We're going to have a chance to talk to you guys a lot more today on Talk Zone 98 Degrees. We'll be back. Animaniacs is up next. That word before, by the
thank
way.
You.
That's how special an occasion this
wow.
is.
Wow. Thank you.
There you go. Thank you very much for being here, guys.
Our pleasure.
What we're going to do right now is we're going to play a little game.
All right.
We have the crazy tree of question answering. Look at this. This is like a short order cook thing, right?
That's Drew up there.
That's me. That's my profile.
Order up. All right, so Justin, pick a question there off the tree.
Pick a good one, Jay.
Here we go.
No, I to actually get to read it myself?
Yeah, you can read it.
Wow. What is Nick's zodiac sign?
Now, let's see. Everybody else has to guess what Nick's zodiac sign is.
You better get it right,
Let me.
These are all things taken from your biographies, by the way.
Let me, remember what Nick's... his zodiac sign is Scorpio.
Yeah.
Right.
Correct.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Wait for a minute, but he bailed himself out.
You didn't know what you were gonna do at first.
At first, I was like, wait, is that what it is, or is it Leo? But all that's right. Drew's sign. Drew is the Leo. He's the Scorpio.
You might have just ruined the next question.
Yeah, that might have been Drew's.
It'll be a little different.
I can answer them all. You guys would be surprised.
Uh-oh.
What doesn't Justin like? Ooh, this is a tough one.
What doesn't?
Besides
third,
huh?
Is this a multiple choice?
No, it's just, what doesn't Justin
Well, I can tell you one
there's
thing.
There's multiple answers, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's Jeff, there's Nick, and there's Drew.
But I can tell you one thing, Justin does not like to wake up early. That's absolutely
true.
Not in his nature.
But I don't know if that's the answer that they're looking for.
Well, it's a place, it's a city.
Oh, it's a place.
Oh, you guys know this one, I think.
England.
London.
No.
London. No?
No.
London, England.
Well, add that to the list.
This one said New York.
Did it?
Yeah.
It's constantly updated.
Now, if you pick London, you pick New York. Can I take from that you don't like big, crowded, busy cities?
Yeah, you could say that. I'm the type of guy that likes to go out to the.
He's like a
frontiersman.
That's right. Yeah, I like to explore.
Him and Davy Crockett go way back.
There's plenty of guys with goatees and earrings and bleach blonde hair out in the country.
Justin's got a Conestoga wagon at home. He's like one of the original settlers. He likes the Wild West.
All right, we'll see.
Oh,
we found something
about
Justin.
What
are you
picking
another one here? Let's try
it. Okay, let's see if we can find one for Nick. Okay, this is just a trivia one.
All right,
is that one? Okay, what is the tallest structure in the world?
Me.
I know this.
No. Should I read the selection?
Sure,
yeah. A, the Empire State Building. B, the CN Tower. C, the Eiffel Tower. Or D, the Tower of London.
You know.
And I don't think that any of these are right.
Well, actually one is right. And because we are here in Toronto,
Canada,
I have to say it is the CN Tower.
Hey!
We have the biggest buildings
Which
in the world.
It's not the largest, tallest building in the world, but the tallest structure.
That's right. That's right.
He is a
Because we've just been to Kuala Lumpur, and I know the tallest buildings are called the... But the tallest structure is the CN Tower.
Very good. A trivia master.
And anyone who hasn't had a chance to go up there and stand on the... the 5-foot thick glass and look down at your death like we had a chance to do. Just try it. It's a real thrill.
But you guys have no problems with heights. We have already seen in your video up on the bridge. So.
Not at all. We will go on top of any hike, any place, any time.
We're skydiving in our next
video.
You
build any structure and we will be skydiving
in the next video.
98 degrees. Daredevils.
That's right. Right.
Extraordinary.
All right, we're going to be coming back with more 98 Degrees right after the next show, guys.
Take a
home. Talk Zone continues.
Yeah.
Here.
Oh, that's right.
I'm presenting there. What's happened in the lives of you guys since then?
Wow, a lot has happened since then. We had the opportunity to record a brand new album, and we got to work with a legend named Stevie Wonder, and we've just been going all around the world and having a great time.
Now, that is something to be, that just must be like the pinnacle.
Definitely. I think that's been one of the highlights of our career. We got to do the song for the Disney soundtrack, Mulan, and we also got to put it on our album, so we're very honored to have Stevie Wonder as a guest on our album, and we got to meet him at the video shoot, and we had a lot of fun. He invited us back to the trailer. We had a jam session, and we also got to perform with him on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, and that was like the highlight. I mean, the energy that the man puts off when he performs
is he really that incredible? Is he a living legend?
Yes, without a doubt.
He walks into a room and everybody just kind of stops and stares and just waits for him to say something. He has such a presence about him, and he still definitely got it, you know, as far as his musicianship and his voice is just awesome.
Do you think he's just one of those guys that has so much talent inside that he could probably just spit out like 8 top 10 hits, like, in 10 seconds?
At the video shoot, he just has harmonica and he was just sitting there jamming, just in his own world, always humming something, playing his keyboards. Music is just constantly flowing through him. I mean, it really is very impressive to watch him. I mean, it's you can learn a lot just by looking at him.
That says a lot. That must be a big compliment for you guys as well, because I mean, he obviously wouldn't do it if he didn't love your music. So
he's been great to us all along. He did a lot for us for Mulan that we can't thank him enough for. So. We
That's
love you,
amazing.
Stevie.
You can check out that song on this album, 98 Degrees. We'll be back after this.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming in. What we're going to do now is we've had a lot of viewers. We've been telling everybody that you guys are coming in, so a lot of people are taking the time out to write some questions because apparently they don't think I can interview well enough. So they're going to take over.
Now, how would they ever come to that?
They've been watching for a while. Anyway, the first one comes from Katrina, and she's from Grand Prairie, Alberta. Do you ever get annoyed with each other?
Katrina, to answer your wonderful, very... good question. I'd have to say, without a doubt, yes.
The question is, do we ever not get annoyed with each other? Nah, we're like a family. I mean, once you're with somebody for so long
he asked to answer every question, see? No, I'm just kidding.
You get on each other's nerves after a long time, but, I mean, there's no, like, grudges or anything. It's the next day is a new day, and you just go on with it. We all have the same goals, and we are like four brothers, so.
Now, we were talking a little bit before we came on camera right now. Guys used to live together, but you don't now. Right?
Yeah, we first got together in LA. We shared a 2-bedroom hacienda in North Hollywood, and we moved to New York and lived together in New York, and we moved to Brooklyn and lived together in Brooklyn. So for about 2.5 years, we all lived in 2-bedroom apartments all across the country.
But now we live together on the road.
Yeah,
so
now
it's the same thing.
Now
we just don't have a place to go home to.
But yeah,
it's a lot of fun.
We do spend a lot of time together, and I always have. We've always kind of lived together. I think that kind of helps when you're a group to get that bonding time together.
Cool. Permanent road trip.
Yeah,
exactly.
Permanent road trip. Okay, following up on that. Lindsay would like to know, where do you guys see yourselves in 10 years or so?
Well, Lindsay, that's another good question. And hopefully...
they're all good questions.
That's right. Hopefully...
Lindsay, that question was terrible. Next question.
No, hopefully we'll be able to just keep on doing what we're doing. We're having a lot of fun. We got to do a lot of writing and producing on this latest album, and we're very proud of that. So hopefully we'll be able to work with a lot of other artists and maybe do some writing and some more collaborating with other artists and producers, and just keep having fun, seeing the world, and making great music.
That sounds good.
We'll probably have a little gray hair, which, you know, might change the dimension of the group. I've got a few right now. But no, as long as we keep having fun, we'll still be doing it.
All right, let's do this here. Another one. What are your favorite movies from Francine and Heather?
Wow.
Favorite films?
Favorite
films. Another great question.
Braveheart, Good Will Hunting.
Mine's Die Hard. All three of them.
The trilogy.
Even number three? No, number two is a bad one.
Number two was a little... We'll drop that out of the trilogy. One and three.
Star Wars. The trilogy.
I can't believe he dropped one out.
The greatest.
Come on.
It's still a good movie.
Come on.
The greatest of all time.
I like The Shawshank Redemption. It's a good movie.
Great film. Now, you guys are obviously performers. Has there ever been an opportunity for you to act, to get into some films? You do it in your videos, we know, but why aren't you guys in, like, the new Star Wars film or something?
Actually, more and more people are approaching us about stuff like that, but...
They actually asked Nick to play it. A Wookiee.
I was supposed to be an Ewok.
He's an Ewok and he's a Wookiee.
I play a Klingon in the Star Trek movie and no makeup. It's amazing. It's the first time it's ever been done. I play the young Yoda.
Justin is Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Yeah.
The kind of, you're distinguished a little bit, you know?
That's right, in his younger years.
The brains? Are you the brains behind the operation?
Oh, my goodness.
Uh-oh. There are no brains in this operation.
Trey actually plays Jawa, one of those little guys that you can, it's just the eyes and the hood, the little troll man who walks around.
Guys, I want to thank you very much for coming by today, making our first Talk Zone so special. All the best for the holidays. You have anything to say to everybody? Give them a big Hollywood shout-out.
We love you, and we hope to see you all soon.
Have a good Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Happy New Year. Enjoy yourself.
Love you guys.
90 degrees and rising. Pick it up. You got a taste of it in your home. Thank you very much, guys. 98 degrees.